Hello, intelligent beings of the Etherweb. On August 25th, 2020, a cold-blooded murder had happened. It happened at night, unannounced. At night, Moscow Trolleybus was murdered by Moscow government led by Sergei Sobyanin, a loyal servant of Vladimir Putin. The footage with Trolleybus as shown was taken weeks before, as an unannounced nature of the destruction made it impossible to conduct proper filming and properly cheer the Trolleybus on the way out. In the morning of August 25th, instead of Trolleybus 64, they already were diesel buses Т-64. Neither Mosgortrans, Moscow Bus, Tram and previously Trolleybus Authority, nor Moscow Department of Transport have published anything about the Trolleybus demolition that morning. When I called 3210, the contact center of Moscow Transport, they did not even know that the Trolleybuses were replaced. Since Sergei Sobyanin have been installed as the mayor of Moscow via a largely controversial election in 2013 and sequential uncontested election, he, like the previous mayor Yuri Lushkov, embarked on pet projects of his. First is beautification of the city to his taste, which included nullification of property rights and demolition of private property, as well as continuous retiling of Moscow streets and disposable tiles. Second is renovation, a project to embezzle budget funds in favor of construction companies demolishing five-story residential buildings in favor of high-rises built to special, low-standard renovation allowances. Third are the hordes, a series of highways constructed inside the city, including one currently being constructed on top of an unaccounted nuclear waste deposit. Fourth is the destruction of Moscow Trolleybus. Sergei Sobyanin was seen and still is seen as a progressive mayor by some. He positioned himself as a modernizer, attracting part of the urbanist local activist crowd. His governance was seen by many alongside the lines of enlightened absolutism, how monarchs of Europe saw themselves governing without the people but for the people. The transit of Moscow saw some changes, and urbanists were cheering a few constructed bike lines in the city center. But urbanism at its core is not about bike lines, it's about change made for the people by the people. Moscow government decides the fate of the largest city in Europe as a small group of ungoverned officials, removed away from people, traveling to private elite mansions on private cars. Moscow Trolleybus was being continuously demolished bit by bit for years. First, the routes in the city center were demolished. And in 2015, Moscow have lost the status of the city with the largest trolleybus network in the world, with it now belonging to St. Petersburg. On May 2, 2016, most of trolleybus routes in the city center were demolished. They were trolleybuses at Lubyanka Square in 2016, only buses now at Lubyanka Square in 2020. There were trolleybuses at Teatralnaya Square in 2016, only buses now at Teatralnaya Square in 2020. There were trolleybuses at the corner of Mokhovaya and Vozdvizhenka streets in 2016. Only buses now at the corner of Mokhovaya and Vozdvizhenka streets in 2020. There were trolleybuses at Prechistinskiye Vorota Square in 2016. Only buses now at Prechistinskiye Vorota Square in 2020. On the square of Amilcar Cabral, far away from the city center, where previously one could have boarded trolleybus 30, and until August 25th, 2020, trolleybus 64, there are no more trolleybuses. But there are still plenty of marshrutkas, the small, cramped, dangerous minibuses. I have an official letter by Moscow Department of Transport saying that there are no plans to close down the legendary B trolleybus. Of course, there are now diesel buses there, like this one, very dark inside. Sergei Sobyanin had promised electric buses, supposedly more efficient than trolleybuses. The city government is so proud of their electric buses, they've written "This is an electric bus" in large letters on each one. But the electric buses require separate infrastructure as they are built to completely different charging standards instead of utilizing the existing trolleybus network. Modern trolleybuses can pass long sections without cables on internal batteries, charging them along the way during powered sections. Most routes, like Dimension 30 and 64, have no electric bus infrastructure, and thus are only sorted with diesel buses now. Even where there is some infrastructure, the longest trolleybus route that remained until the end, M4, was too long for electric buses, and as a result it was shortened. The electric buses of Moscow suffer from continuous technical issues and have to be heated using diesel, pretty much meaning that they are not electric from September to April. The electric buses are smaller compared to trolleybuses, and especially smaller than articulated trolleybuses, meaning that in many cases, like with trolleybus 63, the only replacement is an articulated diesel bus. The supposed progressive nature of Mosgortrans can be summed in their actions in the pandemic. The first thing they did when the government admitted that the pandemic exists was to require from all bus, trolleybus and tram drivers to call the police on all people of Chinese nationality, meaning in practice, call the police and escort Asians out. Moscow trolleybus and tram drivers are largely women. By destroying Moscow trolleybus, Moscow government throws trolleybus drivers out, negating years of their experience and forcing them to re-education and onto a position where they, especially in case of women drivers, are put in a disadvantage. This is not my opinion alone. On December 26, 2019, Moscow Duma, Moscow Parliament member Darya Besedina have organized a panel on trolleybuses, where experts and activists have presented their points to the city government. Ivan Kazhushka in his presentation specifically mentioned how the removal of trolleybuses infringes on labor rights, and infringes on labor rights of women in particular. The presentation continues with examples of poor safety, poor maintenance and poor performance of electric buses. The official city government answers to why trolleybuses are banned were at best inconsistent. Moscow government claimed that old trolleybuses and old infrastructure resulted in halts on the lines and traffic jams, but they were saying this at the same time as they were replacing both the rolling stock and the infrastructure, removing the issues. This BKM 321 trolleybus was only built in 2017. Moscow government claims that the cables are ugly, continuing their ungoverned beautification craze. And sure, trolleybus cables are now being demolished, but apparently something like this in the city center is perfectly fine. This outside the city center too. This in between Bolshoi Theater and the Red Square with the Kremlin is also fine. To me, there is nothing wrong with cables, just look at Tokyo. But if Moscow government decided to target cables, they sure do this a bit selectively. Also, to Moscow government perfectly fine are the endless cameras, connected to facial recognition infrastructure, which by the way, was proven to be easily accessible to everyone if you are ready to pay as low as 170 euros. The city government's and Sergei Sobyanin's reaction to specifically the trolleybus cables reminds me of what happened in Seoul, then named Hanson, in 1899. There, electric tram was introduced in May 1899, which actually was the second electric tram that opened in East Asia after Kyoto, preceding the electrification of Tokyo horse tram by 4 years. But in May 1899, Korea also experienced dry weather, and by some, the drought was attributed to the cables disrupting the geomantic harmony and sucking out the water's life energy called gi in Korean. The outreach was such that the tram had to be halted until September, Japanese drivers had to be replaced with American drivers, and the authorities had to add additional security to the tram's power plant. The tram cables were preceded by electric, telegraph and even telephone cables, but it's tram cables which caused the outrage. Georgi Kresnikov in Moscow Duma have presented a total debunk of all the myth exposing the lies of Mayor Sergei Sobyanin and others like the head of Moscow Transport Maxim Liksutov. He had reported, using the official Mosgortrans statistic, that trolleybuses performed better than the replacement buses. He had reported that Russian trolleybus manufacturers, unlike what is stated by Moscow government, they can produce decent modern trolleybuses. He had reported on how the trolleybus infrastructure is not expensive to maintain and renew, and on how the infrastructure was actually being renewed recently, but it is the electric bus infrastructure that is expensive to build from scratch. By the way, the son of the head of Moscow Transport Maxim Liksutov is an illegal street racer that was never punished for illegal races, and at the time he was exposed as a street racer he was 15 years old, while the earliest age at which one can have a driving license in Russia is 16. Oskar Liksutov had traveled to Courchevel in France during the pandemic because Maxim Liksutov's wife and son have Estonian, European Union citizenship and are allowed to travel during the pandemic. When the boy have returned to Moscow, he have not spent the obligatory 14 days in quarantine, which is punishable by law, but instead continuing illegal street racing during the pandemic, even at the time when all non-essential activity was punishable too. As for the mayor of Moscow Sergei Sobyanin, a loyal servant of Vladimir Putin, You can spend days reading about the corruption schemes he and Moscow government he controls are intertwined with. Moscow trolleybus had opened on November 15, 1933. The network had survived the Stalinist era. The network had survived the Second World War, with the battle for Moscow of 1941 to 1942, and continuous air raids until 1943. What Heinz Guderian, Fyodor von Bock and Adolf Hitler could not do to Moscow trolleybus, Sergei Sobyanin and his clique did. Moscow trolleybuses were used as barricades by people protecting the new Russia from the communist coup of August 1991. The trolleybuses with their bodies had protected the hope for democracy, freedom and future. Perhaps this is another reason why Sergei Sobyanin, the loyal servant of Vladimir Putin, hates trolleybuses so much. Raccoon hugs, everyone! Remember to subscribe here and on Patreon. And remember that Salzburg and Vienna are beautiful places, and they have trolleybuses.